Now, if you're feeling a bit tight on the purse strings after overindulging during the holiday season, you are not alone. Making a New Year's resolution to get your finances into shape is one of the most popular for Australians, according to new research. Here to tell us how we can commit to our savings goals for 2012 is financial advisor Noel Whittaker. And Noel, if we want to get off on the right financial foot for the year, what are your tips?
If you're going to move forward, you must know where you stand now. Therefore, your first job is to do up an asset and liability statement and also write down your income and your expenses. And then you can find out if you're living beyond your means or whether you are really gaining.
Noel, is making a budget the only way to go?
You know, in the next 15 years, the average Australian is going to earn more than $1 million. How you will be at the end of that time depends entirely on how you use that money. So I think a budget is the best way for most people, yes.
Now, Noel, this is the crucial question. The summer sales are upon us. How can we stay focused and not feel tempted to spend on what we don't need? Because I cannot walk past a sale.
It all gets back to goals. I mean, your goal should be your dominant thought. So if your goal is to reduce your debt or reduce your housing loan or save for a holiday, that must be the dominant thought. And then you will walk past the sales because the goal becomes more important than going into the big department stores.
And New Year's resolutions don't have a good track record of lasting. I've certainly given up on the gym already. What can we do to make sure that we stick at least to our financial goals?
Well, look, don't try and do too much and involve the family and have a weekly get-together to talk about it. And once you start to make a little bit of progress, then the rest will follow. So just start small, but just go slowly but surely.
Slow and steady wins the race. Whittaker McNaught's Noel Whittaker.
Absolutely.
Thank you.